Hello students, hope you all are safe and healthy. I'm your teacher, Dr. Rahul Deshpande. Today we are going to learn a very interesting topic. It's all about the basic unit of every living organisms, that is basic structure of a cell. Firstly, we will take a look about the history. Rudolf Karl Virchow, he was the German physician, pathologist, biologist, writer and politician even. He is known as the father of modern pathology and the founder of social medicine. In 1855, Virchow published a statement based on his observations, Omnis cellula cellulae, that which means that all cells arise from pre-existing cells. Virchow used the theory that all cells arise from pre-existing cells to lay the groundwork for cellular pathology or the study of disease at the cellular level. Virchow put a cell theory which was based on three components. The first one was all living organisms are made of cells, and the second one, cells are the basic unit of life for all living things, and the third one is all cells arise from pre-existing cells. The cells are of different types. Different types of cells are formed from a single cell, that is stem cell. Today we know about the cells, but who was the first to observe the cells under the microscope? In 1665, Robert Hooke used a microscope to examine a thin slice of cork, that is dead plant cells. He was able to see a bunch of small boxes. Hooke is responsible for naming the small boxes as cells. He called them cells because they looked like the small rooms that monks live in, called cells. Anton von Leeuwenhoek, in 1673, a Dutch microscope maker, was the first to view organisms or living things. He used simple microscopes to view pond water and scrapings from his teeth. So, how the cells theory was begin? In 1838, a German botanist named Matthias Schleiden concluded that all plants were made up of cells. Schleiden is a co-founder of the cell theory. In addition to this, in 1839, a German zoologist, Theodor Schwann, concluded that all animals were made up of cells. Schwann also co-founded the cell theory. In 1855, a German medical doctor named Rudolf Virchow observed under the microscope cells divide. That is, two cells are formed from the division of first cell. So, what we came to know from the cell theory, that all living things are made up of cells. Cells are the basic unit of structure and function in an organism. That is basic unit of life. Cells come from the reproduction of existing cells. Now we will see the constituent organelles of the cells. Initially, we must know that these organelles are very small, that is, they are microscopic. They can perform various functions for a cell. They all are found in the cytoplasm. The organelles may or may not be membrane bound. To start with, cell membrane or plasma membrane. It is composed of double layer of phospholipids and proteins surround outside of all cells. These membrane controls what enters or what leaves the cells. It is a living layer of a cell. In this diagram, we can see the structure of a cell membrane. Here we can see the membrane bound proteins, carbohydrate chains on the outside, and protein channels and lipid bilayer of the cell membrane. The channels carries the molecules in and out of the cell membrane. The controlling organelle, that is the nucleus. The cell's nucleus is in the middle of the cell's cytoplasm. Cytoplasm is the liquid that fills the cell. The nucleus takes 10% of the cell's volume. Inside its fully enclosed nuclear membrane, it contains the majority of the cell's genetic material. It is the large organelle of the cell. Each cell has fixed number of chromosomes that carry genes. Genes control the cell characteristics. The next one is nuclear envelope. The nuclear envelope, also known as the nuclear membrane, is made up of two lipid bilayer membranes, which in eukaryotic cells surrounds the nucleus, which encases the genetic material. The nuclear envelope consists of two lipid bilayer membranes, an inner nuclear membrane and an outer nuclear membrane. It has nuclear pores for materials to enter and leave the nucleus. Inside the nucleus, a chromosome contains hundreds of thousands of genes. Every normal human cell contains 23 pairs of chromosomes for a total of the 46 chromosomes. As we all know that the DNA is the hereditary material of the cell. DNA contains the instructions needed for an organism to develop, survive, and reproduce. The next one is nucleolus. The nucleolus is the distinct structure present in the nucleus of eukaryotic cells. Primarily, it participates in the assembling the ribosomes, altering of transfer RNA, and sensing cellular stress. The nucleolus is composed of RNA and proteins. The next one is cytoskeleton. As the skeleton helps us to maintain our shape, the cytoskeleton also helps the cell to maintain its cell shape. This also helps the organelles to move around. The cytoskeleton is made up of proteins. Microfilaments are thread-like and made up of a substance called as actin. Microtubules are tube-like and made up of tubulin. Cytoskeleton is a complex dynamic network of interlinking protein filaments present in the cytoplasm of all cells, including bacteria and archaea. It extends from the cell nucleus to the cell membrane and is composed of similar protein in the various organisms. Actin filaments are linear polymers of globular actin subunits and occur as microfilaments in the cytoskeleton and as thin filaments. Microtubules are polymers of tubulin that form part of the cytoskeleton and provide structure and shape to the eukaryotic cells. Microfilaments are also called actin filaments, are polymers of the protein actin that are part of cells cytoskeleton. They are long chain of G actin formed into two parallel polymers twisted around each other into a helical orientation with a diameter between 6 and 8 nanometer. The next one is centrioles. One of the pair of cellular organelles that occur especially in animals are found near the nucleus, function in the formation of the spindle apparatus during cell division, and consist of a cylinder which 9 microtubules arranged peripherally in a circle. The next one is mitochondrion. Is a membrane bound organelle found in the cytoplasm of eukaryotic cells. It is the powerhouse of the cells. It is responsible for cellular respiration and production of ATP in the cells. Then mitochondria is surrounded by double membrane. It has its own DNA. Folded inner membrane are called as Christi. increases surface area for more chemical reactions. Interior is called as matrix. The interesting fact is mitochondria come from cytoplasm in the egg cell during fertilization. Therefore, you inherit your mitochondria from your mother. The next one is ER, that is endoplasmic reticulum. The endoplasmic reticulum can either be smooth or rough, and in general its function is to produce proteins for the rest of the cell to functions. The rough endoplasmic reticulum has on it ribosomes, which are small round organelles whose function is to make those proteins. Rough endoplasmic reticulum is an organelle found in the eukaryotic cells. Its main function is to produce proteins. It is made up of cristine tubules and vesicles. The cisternae are made up of flattened membrane ducts, which are involved in the modification of proteins. Smooth endoplasmic reticulum. Mesh network of fine disc-like tubular membrane vesicles, part of a continuous membrane organelle, which in the cytoplasm of eukaryotic cells, that is involved in the synthesis of storage of lipids, including cholesterol and phospholipids, which are used in the production of new cellular network. Then ribosomes are minute particles consisting of RNA and associated proteins that function to synthesize proteins. Proteins are needed of many cellular functions, such as repairing damage or directing chemical processes. Ribosomes can be found floating within the cytoplasm or attached to the endoplasmic reticulum. A Golgi apparatus or Golgi body, also known as Golgi apparatus, is a cell organelle that helps process and package protein in lipid molecules, especially proteins distributed to be exported from the cell. Named after its discoverer Camillo Golgi, the Golgi body apparatus as the series of stacked membranes. In this way, the materials are transported from rough ER to Golgi to the cell membrane by vesicles. This is the way the materials are transported. Then we will see about the lysosomes. It is a membrane-bound cell organelle that contains digestive enzymes. Lysosomes are involved with various cell processes. They break down excess or work out cell parts, they may be used to destroy the invading viruses and bacteria. Cilia and flagella. These organelles are required for movement into the liquid part. Cilia and flagella move liquid part, the surface of the cell. For single cells such as sperm, this enables them to swim. For cells anchored in a tissue like the epithelial cells lining our air passages, this moves liquid over the surface of the cell. Then the vacuoles is a membrane bound organelle. They are a kind of vesicles. Vacuoles are closed sacs made up of membranes with inorganic or organic molecules inside, such as enzymes. They have no set shape or size, and the cell can change them as if wanted. They are in most eukaryotic cells and do many things. So this is the general structure of the cell. Little variations are there according to the different structure and functions of the different cell types. Here we can see RBCs, muscle cells, nerve cells, paramecium and other type of cells. Thank you.